Sometimes it's hard to stay grounded in this ever-changing world, but there is one thing that stays the same. So how do we stay relevant in this rapidly shifting society, and how does it relate to the will of God for us? That's what we are here to talk about. This is Covenant Conversations.
Welcome to Covenant Conversations. I'm David Huskins, and I want to thank you for joining me today as we look into the Word of God and we look at the society around us and talk about relevant issues from a biblical worldview. I am so concerned about the state that this nation is in right now with ways and means that the enemy seeks to divide and separate the people of God. And I want to talk to you today about going from being a racist to a gracist. If we really are people of grace, then it's time for us to find our identity in Christ. The Bible says you are not saved by works, but you are saved by the grace of God. If we're not careful, we're going to go back to an ideology of finding our identity somewhere other than in Christ. In our society today in America, at this very time as I speak to you, many people are dividing along racial lines. I got to tell you that, as Dr. King said many years ago, injustice anywhere is injustice and a threat to injustice everywhere. I believe justice ought to be served for all. But if we're not careful, we will allow crises, situations, traumas, we'll allow very negative circumstances, and yes, even the absolute taking of life, we will allow those things to divide us along racial lines when the truth of the matter is, we are one blood. Acts chapter 17 says that he has made every one of us of one blood from every tribe, kindred, tongue, and nation. Not many voices, not many nations, but one blood. God made all of us one. The work of the enemy from the day that Jesus Christ paid the price on the cross has been to seek to divide what God made one. He hath made of two flesh one new man. He hath taken of many and made one new blood. That's the word of God. The word of God says that not only if we are in Christ, we're a new creation, it also declares that in Adam all die, but in Christ all shall be made alive. In America right now, we're facing this real media madness, that I would call it, of where there's a lot of attention being given to the death of Trayvon Martin, a tremendous tragedy in our nation. But that's been turned into something that if we're not careful, it gets exploited, and then one race begins to divide against another race. And listen, the reality is injustice is not a skin issue. Injustice is a sin issue. Murder is not a skin issue. Murder is a sin issue. And when people's hearts are corrupt, no matter the color of their skin, it is the corruptness of their heart that causes them to do the things that they do. But when you and I accept Jesus Christ in our heart, we do not become better people. We become new people. It doesn't say we are made better in Christ. It's we're made new. An old man becomes a new man when Jesus Christ enters his life. It is time for you and I to stand up and say there is not many different nations and nationality and skin colors and races, but there is one blood, and it's the blood of Jesus that has made us one. You know, people get a little nervous and upset with me when I say Jesus was a biracial baby or an interracial baby, because his mother was of the human race, but his father was of the divine race. When the human and the divine come together, it created the Savior of the world. I don't think it's an accident that Jesus was born of both divine and human, because it was his way of saying, I identify with all of humanity. And when a person gets born again by the blood of Jesus, they no longer have an allegiance to their natural DNA. You get a new spiritual DNA. We know that DNA is a scientific term, but in a spiritual term, you could take those same letters and call it divine nature activated. DNA, divine nature activated. When you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, the divine nature of Christ is activated in your life. And when that divine nature is activated, you become transformed by the renewing of your mind into a brand new believer. We must make up our mind that we will not be divided. I have cried loud and long against what I believe injustice of what's taking place in Sanford, Florida with Trayvon Martin's murder. I do believe he was murdered. I don't know if it was racially motivated or not. Time will tell all of that. But the motivation is still one of the heart. Every murder is a murder that is motivated by a heart condition, not a skin condition. The color of one's skin does not determine whether or not they are right or wrong. As a matter of fact, we have people killing each other, white on white crime, black on Hispanic crime, Asian on Asian crime. It crosses every boundary because sin knows no color. Sin is a heart condition. But just as sin is a heart condition, grace knows no color either. There is no race in God, but there is grace. In God, the race becomes the human race. And God so loved the world that there is neither black or white, bond nor free. We're one by the Spirit of the Lord. As a matter of fact, Abraham's seed, we are the seed of Abraham. We are the sons of God. We're a chosen generation. We're witnesses for all the world to see. And as a result of that, we're not black or white. We're not bond or free. In fact, we're no earthly race. We're a brand new breed. We are the people of God. And as the people of God, we should throw away racism and embrace gracism. But if you're not careful, it won't just be race that we will separate on, because the truth of the matter is, God is looking for somebody that will say, we are one blood. And really, at the root of racism, at the root of every kind of negative, ugly, bitter dispute in our country, at the bottom of it is prejudice. Prejudice means to prejudge. And if you prejudge someone, you are making a grave mistake. Prejudices must die. And if it's not black and white, it'll be fat and skinny, tall and short. It'll be one nation over another nation. Who's the chosen people? The truth of the matter is, God so loved the world. He didn't love a race of people. He didn't love a certain skin color of people. He loved all of humanity. It's not by race, it's God's grace. It's not skin, it's sin. The cure for a sin problem is the grace of God. And if we will allow the grace of God to cover the sin, then all of a sudden we will not judge anybody by their skin. In fact, we won't judge people by the color of their skin, the color of their eyes, the color of their hair. We won't say that one's black, that one's white. We won't judge people because they're poor or rich, because they are young or old, because they're in one nation or another nation. We won't judge them because they're heterosexual or homosexual. We won't judge people based on their identities in Adam. We will judge them based on their identity in Christ. Because the truth is, in Adam, we're all sinners. But in Christ, we've all been made righteous. If you draw your identity in Adam, you're going to see yourself as white or black or Hispanic or Latino or whatever your ethnicity may be. If you draw your identity in Adam, you'll see yourself as rich or poor, gay or straight. You will see yourself in all of those things. But if you see yourself in Christ, you will cast off every other identification and say, I don't find my identification in Adam. I find my identification in Christ. And in Christ, we are one blood. And the man that used to be is no more. Judge no man by the flesh, but know every man by the Spirit of God. That's my covenant challenge to you today. And I believe that with the grace of God, we can overcome any division of race. And by the grace of God, we can cure the sin problem that causes people to focus on skin. It's not skin, it's sin. It's not race, but grace. You find your identity in Christ, not in Adam. In Adam, all die, but in Christ, all are made alive. Thank you for tuning in to Covenant Conversations.
And now, Father, we pray for Sanford, Florida. We pray for a city on the brink of self-destruction. Don't let them blame each other and turn on each other. Let that stop today. We pray for the spirit of confusion over Sanford, Florida, that is spreading across this land and going into every city. We pray that there would be no division, that the trick of the enemy to cause us to distrust each other and to divide from each other, that spirit be broken in the name of Jesus. Lord, in Sanford, Florida, raise up a move of the Holy Ghost, a move of the Holy Ghost that unites the men and women of God, that unites the men and women of faith. Bring justice for this child, but not at the expense of killing others. Let there be no more bloodshed in that city. Let comfort and peace prevail in this nation.